Hello guys, welcome back to my video. I'm Mastak. In today's video, I'm going to test this Flipkart Smart Bike stabilizer. It is actually a AC stabilizer which work in 170 to 270 volt. Here as you can see here. Last time I uploaded a short video of unboxing. Actually that is a this stabilizer. If you want to see its unboxing, I put the link somewhere here, you can go and check out. This is how the stabilizer look. It's little heavy. Yeah, it should be heavy because inside it has step up transformer. Okay guys, this is how the cosy of this stabilizer. As you can see here, little scratches. It's because I try to hook the stabilizer. And talking about this hook, it's actually if you are using a VG400 V-guard stabilizer, then the hook is little different. You can mount it properly. You need to drill another hole, and also this thing came with the stabilizer. Stick this wall and drill the hole. It's very easy, and also we got some screws in the box and a manual. Actually, I'm going to test this stabilizer. It is first of all, first I thought that it should be fun to remove and check what's inside and test all the things, but now I don't want to remove it because it will avoid the warranty. But I'm not going to buy this. I'm going to return. Tell you about why I'm going to return. The reason first for is this stabilizer is just, we can say, not a good stabilizer. It is just a cut out box or whatever. When the low voltage happened, it also slowly cut off, which is very bad for AC compressors. As you can see here, it says 8 second timing delay, but I don't see any delay when we connect the power. It start turning on. Okay guys, let's do testing. Okay, let's start the video. I'm using this sewing machine regulator to decrease the voltage. I don't have any step down transformer, so I'm using this kind of setup. You can see cut off and main on LED. Main on LED is white and cut off is red. Cut off happens, it indicate a red LED, and when main's on, it indicate a white LED. The white LED actually it's little bright, we can say, because of the white color. But if you have any irritation, then you can use a little tap on this. But nowadays the stabilizer are used in outdoor, not indoor. If you are using in indoor, then you can use a little tap to hide the or dim the light. Okay guys, let's connect this and check. First of all, I will. Okay guys, now I am connecting to this two terminal. One is nothing. Only these two terminal is active. One is blank terminal. Okay guys, I connected successfully. Now I want to power this thing, and its output is, when we didn't press, it actually didn't conduct any current, and when we step slowly, it actually conducted 120 volt, and when we press fully, it actually bypass the current and full grid current pass into this stabilizer. So I am going to check the time delay. I don't see any time delay. I will show you. And now I am going to connect a clamp meter to the output side, so you can see the output voltages. Okay, let's connect it. Okay guys, now I connected a clamp meter to the output side. No output voltage. Now I'm going to press this button, and it start right away, and now we are getting to 36 volt. Oh shit. Now we are getting to 36 volt, and whenever the I hope now you can see. Now it's 168, 169 output, and it's off, and it's right away turn on. There is no any delay or something. It's a company claimed that it has 8 second delay, but I don't see any delay, as you can see. Now the LC, now the stabilizer cut off. I'm going to turn on. 1, 2, 3. I think 3 or 2 second delay, but in the manual it has 8 second delay, but there is no 8 second delay. Now I'm going to put this thing into a low voltage. You can observe in the output voltage how many voltage is giving to the output, and when is the stabilizer is actually cutting off the volt. It's turned on, and 167. And it cut off. The reason why it's suddenly cutting off, it's because I'm slowing the pressing. It actually go, the regulator will put 120 volt, so it's suddenly cutting off. That's good, but I don't give any load. And now it's again 139. Now what, again I am going to put a low voltage, and again suddenly I am going to give a 213 volt, so it should be get some 8 second delay to turn on again, but we can check again. Now cut off, and again I am giving a full voltage. It's suddenly, I think, only 2 second or 3 second delay, but that's not enough. So it's actually, we can say, not doing good job. And also it only boosted 10 volt. As you can see, this is how the voltage stabilizer is working. Turn by this stabilizer if your ASC, if you do want to protect your ASC, buy any go for Microtech or any other brand, or if you want to try V-Guard, then go and try. But V-Guard also, I think, only boost 10 volt or 20 volt or something, but V-Guard stabilizer actually cut off the current faster, and also it gives some delay, which is very good for compressors. If you have a very low voltage in your home, and you don't want to buy this stabilizer, it only goes to 117 and also not doing a perfect output voltage, you can buy 113 volt to 300 volt stabilizer, which will say triple stabilizing or something like that, and you can go for that. It actually little pricey, it costs about 4000 or something rupees, but it actually do the job well. Like, it is actually a well stabilizer. You can go for V-Guard brand or any other brand. So we can say it's just a cut off on box, not any there is no anything else like delay function or anything, just a cut off box, we can say. It only give you a 10 volt boost, which in low voltage cases, and also for a non-inverter ACs. It is not fine. When I search online, I got the information that a non-inverter AC should have at least, I think, 200 volt or something, and up to 220 volt. That's the fine voltage of non-inverter AC. So guys, if you need any other stabilizer review, I will do it. So anyway, that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy this video and also you got some new information. If you're new to my channel, then do subscribe and turn on the notification bell. Also share with your friends if your friends need a stabilizer, or if your family need a stabilizer, let them know how this stabilizer perform. And also we will do, if you want, we will do some other stabilizer checking. And that's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Got caught up in the moment, getting lost inside emotion. Oh, I can feel you next to me, we're like the waves in the ocean.